There are many tools that we use in trying to find ancient locations of the Bible. Archaeologists use shovels, and they use brooms, brushes, vacuums, all these tools. The greatest tool is the Bible itself. And then you have all these archaeologists that have different opinions, and they say, oh, I think it's there, and I think it's there, and then they fight each other. There's infighting all over the place. Archaeologists like to stay in the safe harbor of mutual consent. They don't want to wade off into the choppy waters of a new concept. And what we're doing right now is we're trying to figure out and answer some locations surrounding where Jesus was crucified. We're trying to find out where he was buried and resurrected. And all of this is lost to history because, like a surveyor, you have to have a pin in the ground, a starting place, to find out where you're going to map out coordinates. The pin has been placed in a wrong place. The pin has been placed up on the Temple Mount, the traditional Temple Mount, where that big iconic gold dome is. And if you get that wrong, everything's going to get wrong.
If we're correct on this, it has huge implications prophetically to when the Antichrist is going to return, when the temple is going to be rebuilt. To me, it's fascinating. To me, I'm seeing the Bible come to life in ways I've never dreamt possible. And when I have done research on where the temple's located, in every page I've turned, it points like a flaming arrow to the city of David. It gets me pretty excited. Why is God allowing this to come to the forefront now? Why didn't it become real popular 100 years ago? Because the evidence has been there. I can only conjecture that right now we're in very interesting times, and that the Bible is literally coming to life right before our eyes.